When photographing the landscape, the best light is often when shooting with the sun behind you. But when you try this, you may find your own shadow ruins the image. In this video, I'll share a two-step approach to removing an unwanted shadow from a photo. The first step is something you should do when taking the photo, and it doesn't involve any editing with Affinity Photo. You need to take steps to minimize your shadow in the frame. The less shadow area you need to remove, the easier the repair will be. Sometimes you can do this by moving to one side, but that might not work. You can clearly see my shadow in this frame because I couldn't move far enough to the side when using a wide-angle lens. That's when I like to mount my camera on a tripod. I can then set the camera to shoot using the timer function set to 2 seconds. Then when I fire the shutter, I can step away before the camera takes a shot. If you have a remote shutter release, you can use that rather than the camera timer. There might also be a camera app for your phone that allows you to do this. Then after taking the shot, you only have the tripod shadow to remove, which is going to be far easier. Now there are a few ways that we could remove the tripod shadow from the photo using Affinity. One great tool for something like this is the Inpainting Brush. It's perfect for easily removing small objects and things like power lines, providing you use it correctly. I'll start by adding a new empty layer to the top of this image. This new layer is where we'll be painting the repair. We're doing this because the Inpainting Brush is a destructive edit. If we use it directly on a pixel layer, it adjusts those pixels and we can't remove the change later. Next, I'll select the Inpainting Brush tool from the Tools palette. The icon looks like a brush with a circle at the tip. You'll find it in the same group as other tools like the Healing Brush, Patch Tool, Blemish Removal Tool, and Red Eye Removal. If any of those icons are visible instead, click the small grey triangle to the bottom right of the icon. This displays all the tools in the group so you can select the Inpainting Brush. You'll then see the Inpainting Brush controls displayed in the Affinity Photo toolbar. Before going any further, check that the tool is set to use the current layer and below. This is how the brush will take a sample to make the repair to remove the shadow. The layer we're using for our repair is empty, so we must set the brush to sample the current layer and below, or it won't do anything. Next, check the opacity and flow are both set to 100%. Sometimes you might need to reduce these settings, but most of the time 100% works best. If we try to remove the shadow with a setting less than 100%, the shadow still shows through and making multiple brush strokes can create a mess. Also check the hardness setting. Whilst it's not as critical, a hardness setting of between 20% and 60% tends to produce a better repair. Now we can begin painting over the shadow to remove it. I'm going to zoom to 100% magnification whilst I do this so I can work with more precision. Size the Inpainting Brush to match the width of the shadow you want to remove, making it a little larger than the shadow area. You can do this using the square bracket keys on your keyboard. The left bracket reduces the brush size and the right bracket makes it larger. It's best to work on small sections of the shadow at a time rather than trying to fix the entire area at once. Sometimes it can work, but often it won't create a good repair. Click at the start of the shadow area you want to remove and then drag to paint over the area. As you paint, you'll see the area to be repaired highlighted with a red overlay. Keep painting until you've covered that section of the shadow. It's only when you release the brush that Affinity Photo completes the repair. What happens when you release the brush is that Affinity searches for a similar area of the image to make the repair with. It then samples that area and merges it with the area you painted over. By repairing small sections of the shadow at a time, it's easier for Affinity to find a section of the image to use. Now continue to paint, removing small sections of the shadow at a time. Don't make these areas too small though, because Affinity doesn't seem to make such a good repair then. You also don't need to try to remove every part of the shadow for it to look good. If I remove the lower part of the tripod in this image, but I leave the section at the top, it looks like a natural shadow. With the shadow gone, the repair looks great. And because the repair is on a separate layer, we can turn it off or on, or even delete it to start again. I hope you found this video helpful. You can find more Affinity Photo videos in my Affinity Photo playlist.